Martin, there's been a lot of talk about a recovery, but there are also simultaneous discussions about a possible second wave. So how do you position your portfolio for this time? Is there opportunity here?
Absolutely. If you look at the tech sector, it's become so difficult to find value opportunities. Whereas if you look at the post recovery, and those sectors have been greatly impacted by the first shutdown and anticipation of the second shutdown, there's a lot of really good value opportunities out there. And so that's because investors have sold those value or those potentially exposed names and worries over a second wave and herded into the digital companies and technology companies. And so that's left a great chasm of opportunities for those who are willing to be a contrarian. Now, we're not suggesting taking a big swing for the fence on this and repositioning your entire portfolio, but rebalancing, taking some of the profit away from the technology stocks within your index. And if you have the S&P 500 within your portfolio, that's 27.5% of the index. Whereas if you look at EFI markets, that's only 9% of their index. And the TSX, it's only 10%. And of that, one stock, Shopify, is 3/4 of that. So rebalancing out of some of those frothier segments of the market, like technology, into the value and recovery stocks, if you're a long-term investor, that means you're looking past the next 6 months. And then that means if you believe that the world's going to be in a better place in 6 months from now, which we do, there's a lot of money to be made in the recovery stocks.
So when you're making that decision about these recovery stocks, ultimately, how do you decide between, is it airlines, is it REITs? What sort of makes that next decision for you?
Risk. And so nobody knows. I mean, there's definitely going to be a transformation of the economy. And that's certainly has been accelerated from the virus and the lockdown. Consumer behavior, and the longer that we undergo this pandemic with the second wave appearing to take root here, the greater it's going to reinforce consumer behavior. And so we want to be careful about that. And we want to be careful about trying to make a binary bet on what's going to be permanent and what's not going to be permanent. So from the risk standpoint, financials, in our opinion, are at the lower end of the risk spectrum. You have really low interest rates. You have housing market that's continuing to boom. You have business growth that is starting to take root again. And that's all positive for the banks. The next level down from that, from risk, would be energy. There's also been a big focus on alternative energy and so-called peak demand. But the point, if you take a look at energy consumption, we're added almost 14 million barrels a day in the last couple of months. And so we're 90% of pre-COVID levels. And yet many stocks are off, 50% from their highs. And so going down that risk standpoint, we think there's some opportunity there. And at the higher end of the risk would be REITs, for example, and airlines. The work from home, is that going to be permanent? Is there going to be a hybrid? How does that impact office space in regards to shopping malls? How much is going to remain online versus visiting bricks and mortars? And airline travel, how comfortable are people going to feel getting on an airplane again? And that would be at the higher risk. And so I think that's probably factored into valuation somewhat if you look at market performance, but you have to be cognizant of those risks.
I want to pick up on a few things that you had just mentioned with respect to a time frame. I heard you say 6 months. I heard you also say that perhaps investors should be playing the long game here. Is that ultimately what you should be doing as an investor?
Absolutely. Trying to make near-term calls and market calls is impossible. Advisors are often thought of, and same with market pundits, thought of being able to make a near-term prediction. And that's where luck gets separated out from skill. And many times it's just luck being in the right place and the right time. But there is some skill involved. For example, being at the early stage of investing in technology during the virus has been proved to be very successful. What we do is we take a balanced approach, owning a little bit of everything, so that when you own them in a portfolio, it reduces the volatility, ups and downs of that portfolio, and enables you to achieve a certain target return that you need to meet for certain objectives, retirement income or buying that boat or whatever the case may be. And so by focusing away from trying to say, I'm going to call the market right, let's weigh probability, weight some of the risks, and look at the valuations and look at the returns, and then take that diversified approach with it.